Hello and welcome back. Animaze is now in general release as of the 17th of November and available on Steam. I thought it'd be good to take a good look around Animaze and a look at the avatars and see how this can make your meetings and classroom engagements fun. Jumping into the Steam client and doing a quick search on Animaze, you can see it's free to play. Clicking on that takes you to the general page. Now, like I say, it's available on the 17th of November. As this video comes out, it will be available. And thank you very much to Holotech Studios for this early press release copy. As you can see, you can change your avatars to different favorites with different backgrounds as well. And they really have done some good work on the facial tracking over the beta. Now I've installed Animaze Desktop on my PC and I've got it linked to my Microsoft Life camera. So we're going to take a look around the interface and get ourselves working. So effectively, we're going to go to the Animaze menu item, the top left-hand corner of the screen. And we're going to pop down. The first thing we're going to look at is avatars. Right, so this time with avatars, you've got a number of points. You can see the points that I've been allocated by Holotech and Facerig in the top right-hand side. So I've got 2,000 credits here. You can use these credits to unlock different avatars. Some avatars are going to come free as standard. For example, I'm using the penguin. I've also got Bruce Chumpster as well that you saw earlier on in the video. So you can select across a number of the preloaded ones. As I also mentioned, there's an editor where you can also make your own. Now, where this slightly differs from Facerig is the fact that you can move your avatars around the screen a bit. So we hold the shift key down and you can move the camera angle. Hold the control key down and you can move your avatar around the screen. Now, I've got a background here. It's a nice sort of Polynesian sort of resort with the pool. And I think that matches Bruce Chumpster's persona quite well. We'll come on to backgrounds in a minute, but we'll go through the process of selecting a different avatar. So if we go through the avatars we've got on the screen, so we've got a little lion cub, we've got Freddy the fish, we've got a toilet roll, a virus, quite topical really, I suppose. They take a little while to load up, but there they are. If for any reason you get a problem where, for example, one eye blinks, the other eye doesn't, holding the control and C down brings up the calibration. Now you can see me with the dots around my chin and my face and around my eyes and the distance of the camera towards me. Clicking calibrate and holding a neutral expression will allow you to calibrate Animaze. Good calibration. And then, as you can see, I haven't got one eye closing and the other eye closing, and the facial expressions on the avatar are a lot better. Okay, so we've got some of the old favorites that have come in from Facerig, particularly the burger. We've got the fox as well, Fluffo the fox. We've got the cat, the bear. I do like the bear. The bear is, I think, one of the best ones on it. And you've got other ones as well with funny favorites. You've got a leaf. You've got a bomb. You've got, what's that, an aubergine, I think. A peach. Trump. I suppose it was topical. And you've got things like toilets and burgers and what have you. And then you've got a load of anime characters as well, which you can unlock for credits. So, and also a pig. So I'm going to go around and I'm going to unlock one. So we'll unlock Trump just for the sake of it. So we'll unlock that for 399 credits by there, unlock that. So I'm purchasing the Trump. It's loading up and here it is. So quite a good model as well. You know, like I said, we can hold the control button down and move it around a bit. So no legs, obviously, but you can set the distance. And of course, holding the shift key down for the camera angle, you can zoom around your particular background. So that's it on avatars so far. So moving on, you can see that I have chosen the Velociraptor for the model. Again, I can press Control and C to hold the calibration. There's that neutral expression. And again, the model resets. So that's all good stuff. Now the background I've got here isn't particularly, it's not conducive to the avatar that I've got. So clicking on backgrounds brings up a number of backgrounds. Now you can see I've got the pool there, and there's a number of preloaded ones. For example, the Senny Vondel Park, we've got a flower road. All these ones have been preloaded by Holotech and Facerig. Okay, some are more apt to others, or you can put your own one in. Now I've got a screenshot from a game I generally play up there as well, but just for, you know, demonstration purposes, clicking on confirm, and there it is. There's my velociraptor again, which I can move around the screen next to my screenshot of choice. Again, backgrounds, click the plus button, and then you can pick a number of other backgrounds. I haven't got anything particularly interesting in there that you can have your avatar up against. For example, I don't know, perhaps say a viper. What that's got to do with dinosaurs, I really don't know. Anyway, but there you go. So we can select a different background. So we'll go for that one there. Confirm flower road, which is probably more apt to our velociraptor. So that was backgrounds, how to select a background and how to load a background into Animaze. Next up, we're going to talk about props. Now you may notice on the bottom bar next to avatars and in between voice, and voice will come on to props. Clicking on props, you've guessed it, is going to be another number of props. You can add comedy hats, change the color, use the sliders to color your hat, select that color, change them, football helmets, witch's hats, headphones. Some are more apt again to some avatars than others. You know, that one's got, you've got a, what is that? That is a plunger on his head. You know, whatever floats your boat really. And no doubt there'll be more avatar prop items coming in the future, which you can buy with your points. So we're going to go for a cowboy hat, right? There it is. It's a little bit too small and it's default sort of like configuration, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to enlarge it. So you've got this slider by here to enlarge the hat, or, you know, make it smaller, tiny little hat. Why you want to do that, I don't know, but you can put a massive hat on this fox's head, or a normal sized hat as well. And again, you can change the colors, make it a bit red, nice red hat. In advanced settings as well, you can mess around with the X and Y positioning, and you can see it's poking above his ears really. So let's go for this axis here. You can raise the hat up and down so it fits perhaps a bit more neatly on your avatar's head, and his ears aren't really poking through. They are poking through a little bit, but not so much. So that's the advanced section, and that's how to use props on your Animaze avatar. Next up in Animaze is going to be animations. Now this is something that we were crying out for really within Facerig, which was animations. Yes, you can move your head from side to side and your mouth moves, and you can close your eyes and you can open your eyes, make them wide, and your eyebrows and all the rest of it, right? That's fantastic. And we can see how all that is tracking in regards to a little picture in picture. So here you go, you can see me with my very sort of busy workspace behind me and my face, and where the dots are tracking me. However, there are also other animations you can use. Clicking the animations button shows you the animations you can use, right, for this particular avatar. So, okay, press the Q key and he waves. Press the W key and he shrugs. Press the E, it's the sort of no, no, no. Okay, and what's next? Press the R button and you get a thumbs up. Now these animations are different for some other avatars as well. So, but it is a quite a good extra dimension you can add, especially if you're using this within meetings like Zoom, Google Meet, BlueJeans, Cisco, that sort of thing, Microsoft Teams. So, yes, indeed, I think it's good. animations. So next up, something I want to talk about is screenshots and record and the broadcast. This button here as well. Now, typically, as with Facerig, you had to broadcast what you were seeing on your screen to get it into a program such as Google Meet. This is exactly the same. Hitting that broadcast button means that you're broadcasting. If you wanted limited time, there's a subscribe button. But for this particular version, I've got 89 minutes where I can use this avatar with a meeting tool like Google Meet, Zoom, Microsoft Teams, BlueJeans, Cisco WebEx, that sort of stuff. Also, just as a matter of point, with Google Classroom, that operates through Google Meet, so you could use that on there if your school or district has not locked that down by something called a group policy, and that would be down to the school admins not being the fun police. Anyway, so as you can see, we've got a number of minutes here that are ticking down as I'm broadcasting. This will then mean I can then put this into a tool like Meet or Teams, and I'll do a video on that in the near future. So as I mentioned, I've put a green screen behind my bear. Now I can record this to my PC. Don't forget, you've also got all your animations there, which you can press and you can record. And then what I can do, I can go into my tool of choice, whether that's Video Studio or any other video editing like Camtasia. I can remove the green from the background and then impose this bear onto, I don't know, a background of choice. Really good for education, really good for sort of bringing a little bit of fun into schools as well. I mean, if you're going to be talking about, I don't know, sharks, for example, for want of a better word, then it'd be so easy to then to record something or record a video for your class and then impose, you know, Bruce the shark on. And then put it on a backdrop to explain, say, something about sharks. You know, using your imagination, dinosaurs, for example, that would be really good. So anyway, we've done a bit of recording here. We're going to stop that. We're then given the choice to save it locally, so we'll click Save As. I've got my videos here in my Animaze folder. We'll select that folder. And it's saved as an MPEG file. Now you can change the MPEG file between MPEG and MP4, and I'll cover that in a minute. Now here you go, I've got my bear, my live feed, and I've also got a file explorer up where I've saved my recording. So double clicking on that, and there's my recording. Okay, now another function that's really important within Animaze is how to set your input. There's an awful lot about having to use your iPhone as a webcam for that, and we'll cover that in another video. But what I want to cover is the actual selection of your own webcam if it doesn't do it by default. This is done by this menu bar down here. As you can see, I've got my live cam is selected. Any other sort of like video input tools like Chroma Cam will also show up here as well, or you can connect your iPhone. So there you go, make sure that your webcam is selected. You can see yourself in that picture in picture, and then Animaze will pick that up and with a bit of calibration transfer your facial expressions to your avatar. So there you have it, everybody. I've changed avatar yet again. That was a quick run through of the functions of the new Animaze application that's available on November the 17th, 2020 on Steam. Take a look, enjoy it, make sure you have some fun, and inject some fun into some meetings. See you soon, and look out for more videos in the series.